YouTube, que lo que mi gente, I hope you guys are all doing well and you guys are all taking safety precautions. In today's video, we're going to talk about the 35mm focal length and its versatility when using it in street photography, street editorial, environmental photography, and some landscape photography. In my experience, the 35mm focal length is a versatile lens to have part of your arsenal. 80% of the time, this is the lens I have on my camera because of its versatility and my shooting style. The 35mm focal length allows me to tell a bigger story on my subject. It allows me to include the environment that is surrounding my subject. This is why I love the lens so much. It's wide enough for me to have my subject in frame, as well including the background where you can add to the story of the subject. Majority of my street editorial work that I have online has been shot on the 35mm lens because I like the perspective it gives me of my subject. It's one of my favorite ones, and no matter what system I'm shooting on, I will always own a prime 35mm. Doesn't matter which one you get, the 2.8 version, 1.8, or 1.4, 1.2. As long as you have a 35, you're good to go. I currently own the size f1.4. I love this lens not only because of its wide aperture, but the contrast that the images have once I capture them. I know you could do this by post-processing the image on Lightroom or Photoshop, but I like the natural look that it gives me. Not only is this lens amazing for sharpness, but this lens has a characteristic already. You know, at 1.4, yes, it's sharp in the middle, it's soft in the edges, but it's a contrast, that crispiness that the lens gives you. That's why I like it so much. Even though this lens has a wide aperture, I tend to use this lens at 2.8 and above, just because sometimes I find that the softness of the bokeh can be a distraction to my subject. So it might get in the way of telling the story. And when I want to include the background, the subject, I think that it's better if I shoot it at f8 or f5 or f3.5. This lens excels at low light photography with aperture of 1.4. You get to reduce the amount of noise that the image gets by opening the aperture to 1.4 and lowering your ISO as low as possible. When collaborating with models and doing street editorial, I tend to use the 35 along with the 85 1.8 because I feel like it gives you two different perspectives and they go hand in hand with one another. In one, you get the perspective of the environment and the subject, and the other one, you get the fine detail of your subject. On the screen, you can see the specs of the size f1.4 and how much it costs in the US. I would recommend getting this lens used from either B&H or Adorama, or maybe from eBay if you guys trust them, but I don't think it's worth getting this lens brand new, since the new Sony 35 f1.8 already came out. It's way smaller and it's half the price of this one. If you guys want to check it out, link down below, click on it, and hopefully you guys enjoy it. I know that there is multiple versions of 35mm out there in the world, and I don't see myself upgrading to them or getting any of those 35, because my work has really grown with the 35 Zeiss 1.4, and I really like the way the images come out when I use this lens. It's exceptional for street photography and street editorial, and that's where my work is most based on. This is why I use it the most. It's one of my all-time favorite lens that I own in my arsenal, and I would recommend you guys to get a 35, whether you're shooting with Canon, Nikon, Fuji, doesn't matter what system you're shooting on, I think you should have a 35mm on your arsenal. If you guys enjoyed today's video, hit the subscribe button, hit the bell notification, hit the like button, and leave a comment down below. Let's have a conversation. What 35mm focal length company provides the best lens? Comment down below, and yeah, I'll see you guys later. Hey, this lens really excels at low. Oh my God.